See, I don't have a degree in real estate. So what I would do is I would pull in a lot of real estate offices and see what we can do to help residents who are in foreclosures, get with banks, have different types of community events to see what we can do to stop these foreclosures, because we have a lot of foreclosures because of taxes. These homes are paid off, paid in full, but because the taxes in the city of Plainfield are so high, they're losing their homes to the city tax base. So we as a city, we would have to work with these residents to try to find a way to come up with a plan to help them save their homes.
Thank you. Mr. Matt.
The problem with foreclosures is a national problem. It's one that has been brought upon us by financial institutions. And the solution lies in federal legislation that will prevent the predatory practices of financial institutions that exploited so many people and forced them out of their homes. And so that is an issue that must be addressed at the state and federal level. In terms of the abandoned homes, many of these homes that are abandoned were foreclosed on by banks. And we are aggressively pursuing different avenues to force the banks to take care of these properties, because it's a cost to the city because of the services that we have to provide. And so we are currently looking at legislation. We're also talking to state representatives to give us more of a hammer so that we can address the problem of abandoned properties across the city. So we are aggressively working on tackling these abandoned properties, holding the banks accountable who are at the root of the problem.
Thank you. Dr. Davis Ibezi.
Well, the answers in the future of what they will do. The answers should be in the past of what they should have done. City Hall should have been talking to these banks well before now, requesting a meeting with the banks and looking at solutions to these problems. You do not need a rocket scientist to tell you this. If you do not talk to the banks, and if it takes warning the banks, you will not be able to make a difference in the lives of the citizens of the city. You must be able to reach out to the banks and say, listen, we have this problem. Come in and talk to us. We should be able to do that. You do not need a rocket scientist to do it. So let us not talk of the past. Let us do it now. And it would take replacing all those who have been in office before and bringing in the new blood like myself. Thank you.
Say this very quickly. Mayor Mapp has mentioned my name three times, and three times he's given wrong information. No one serving on the Board of Education is managing my campaign. I think he's talking about some board members who once managed his campaign and got him involved in politics. But anyway, to answer the question, to reduce the high foreclosure rate, there are programs that are available to help people who are in foreclosure. I work with Reverend Dr. Buster Service at the First Baptist Church of Lincoln Garden, and he has implemented programs throughout the state that have helped people with foreclosure. So I would definitely introduce our city to some of those programs. And the abandoned homes, we have to request that the banks, you know, keep up the property when houses are abandoned. And we have to really hold them, you know, to the fire and let them know that we're not going to tolerate abandoned buildings in our neighborhood that they own.
Thank you. The last question for the evening before the closing remarks. Plainfield has continually missed getting to the 50,000 people count in the census, which would allow it to be a city receiving support directly from the state and federal government. What will you do to ensure that Plainfield is fully counted in the 2020 census? And Dr. Davis Ibezmin, you go first.
The name is Ibezmin. Just remember Ibez and then Zin. As your new mayor from next year, you will know how to pronounce the name very well. Now to the question, the minister.
At 50,000 people in the census, you would be eligible for receiving receiving support directly from state and federal government, and what are you going to do to ensure that Plainfield gets their full count in 2020?
Again, when census has been taken, we know.
I already see a sign of 30 seconds.
Again, when census has been taken, you do not need a rocket scientist to count the people in Plainfield. We are well close to 60,000 people in Plainfield. People have a special interest in putting that number below 50,000. And since you know that, you have to count the people yourself and make sure you know the numbers. If the city needs to do its own census, the city must get into the business of conducting the census in the city. So that's what we will do. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Matt.
Well, I have good news for you. Our population is over 50,000. When I took office, we had the opportunity to go it alone.